The best feature within Toon Boom Harmony is the ability for each layer to have four inner art sublayers: overlay, line art, color, and underlay sublayers. These allow for some extreme flexibility during animation. What is an art layer? Each drawing layer has a set of art layers. You are able to divide your artwork into different layers without resorting to using different drawings. It also allows you to separate the art layers during your compositing stage within the node view, allowing for some additional flexibility. Art layers can also be either bitmap or vector, and can be independent in that choice from one art layer to another, giving flexibility on how you use them. You can switch between which art layer you are drawing on by finding the art layer toolbar and selecting the relevant art layer. By default, Harmony only has line art and color art enabled. To enable overlay and underlay art layers, which I highly recommend, go to Harmony Preferences within the Advanced tab and select the Support Overlay and Underlay Arts option. Art layers allow for some extreme flexibility while working. You could use the overlay layer for annotations and corrections, use the art layers to create an auto patch system like seen here, use the underlay layer for your sketch, which is extremely helpful in keeping your scene clutter free, and being able to change the order of a part of a drawing later in production. The possibilities are endless. Within the camera view, by default, you will see all the art layers at once. If you would like to focus on your current art layer, you can select the current drawing on top button at the bottom of the camera view. This will hide the art layers not currently selected. If you have this option selected, to show the other art layers, you must select the Preview All Art Layers option within the Art Layer toolbar. Within the drawing view, you will only see the art layer you currently have selected. To show the other art layers, you must select the Preview All Art Layers option within the Art Layers toolbar. To edit multiple art layers at once, if the tool supports it, there is a button called Apply to Line and Color Art within the Tool Properties window. Within the Selection tool, it is this button. This will apply whatever action you use the tool for to all art layers, including underlay and overlay art layers. There are multiple ways to create color art from a line art layer. With something selected, whether that be a pencil stroke or a brush fill, you can use the Create Color Art from Line Art button. This is found either within your tool properties window or found within the camera or drawing view toolbars. You can see this is creating an empty fill on the color art layer, which I can now fill. To get more granular control, you can shift left click on this button to gain more configuration options. This includes rendering the drawing for Harmony to base its color art fills from, selecting the source art layer that contains the line art, the destination art layer for where the strokes must go, whether Harmony should clear the art layer before applying, and whether you want Harmony to perform the line art to color art action immediately after clicking OK, or whether you want to just close the configuration window and let you click the button later. Alternatively, if you want to create the color art strokes at the time of drawing the line, there's a button called Automatically Create Color Art within the Brush and Pencil Tool Properties window. So if I draw a box and go to the color art, you see it's created invisible strokes. One of the benefits of using either of these two methods is if you are using a textured brush, the options create the color art based on the center line of the fill rather than the edge as the paint bucket would. So you can see with a textured brush, a paint bucket stops at the edge of the fill. If I instead use our button up here, you can see it goes all the way to the middle of the line, creating a better fill. You can show and hide art layers in different ways. If you're using the art layers for creating a sketch, you can stop the art layer from appearing within your render by disabling it within your layer properties. Right click on your layer, layer properties, go to the drawing tab, and enable or disable the relevant art layer. Alternatively, there are nodes for each art layer: underlay, color art, line art, and overlay. These will show the relevant sublayer. There's also the layer selector node, which gives you options to hide and show multiple art layers. The settings within these also include a few different options, such as flatten, which will remove the line art from layers that are being overlapped by another. For instance, if you applied a selector node to a composite. By default, placing one of these nodes below a cutter node using a mask will only apply the selector node to the drawing, not to the mask drawing. Apply to map port on input effects makes it so it also applies to the mask. So what we have here is a drawing that is being put into a cutter. So this left and right is on the color art layer. The mask has an overlay art layer, which has it on the left hand side, and the line art has it on the right hand side. So if we go to our preview, with this disabled, if I disable line art and overlay, you see it doesn't change anything. The mask is always present. If I enable apply to matte ports on input effects, you see this now affects which layers of the mask are being applied. Here are a few practical examples of art layers in use in my latest client project, which is an app you can download on Google Play. The cuff on the arm is one single drawing layer, but allows me to have part of the layer on top, whilst the other part of the layer appears below. This stops my node network from being too cluttered from multiple drawing layers for one aspect of the animation. This is achieved by having an underlay layer that is separated off from the rest of the drawing, and everything else is as normal. So I can apply one part of the layer to go under and one part to go over. The hair animation has three separate art layers. We have the line art on the line art layer, the face fill on the color art layer, just a temporary color on the underlay layer. What we do, since this gradient has to be one continuous gradient, and it wouldn't work if there were two separate layers, we first use a layer selector to show everything but the hair layer. We take the underlay to replace the fill of the fringe, and then we replace the fill of the fringe with the rest of the gradient, so it looks like one continuous color. You can also utilize art layers for creating an auto patch system. Onion Skin did a great video showing off how these work. An auto patch basically makes two separate objects appear as if they are one, and there are multiple techniques you can use to make this look more advanced. In conclusion, this is one of the greatest features that Harmony has. It gives flexibility to each drawing layer and can be used in a multitude of different ways.